Hi everyone, I am Rahul Kumar and today's topic is Globalizing Indian Rupee. So let's discuss in detail. Currently, global trade and the economy are going through a difficult time, especially after the COVID-19 infected recession and the renewed geopolitical tension in Eastern Europe. Many developing countries in Asia, Africa and Latin America are on the verge of currency crisis with severe foreign exchange shortage and volatility. Even if not all for the all crisis, the US often weaponizing the US dollar against its adversaries by imposing sanctions on them, example Iran, Russia, etc., has led the countries across the globe to took alternate means of trade and payment settlement. For this gesture, an alternative arrangement of USD-based settlement system with using Indian rupees INR could be a win-win for both India and the countries facing sanctions by the US. RBI decision to promote Indian rupee for cross-border trade is undoubtedly a step in the right direction. However, such internationalization requires a number of short-term and long-term action. Internationalization of rupees. Internationalization currency is one that is used instead of national currencies of the parties directly involved in the international transactions, whether the transactions in question involves to purchase of goods, services or financial. By 2022, USD account for about 88% of global foreign exchange market turnover, followed by Euro, Japanese Yen and Pound Sterling. The Indian rupee account for mere 1.7%. Internationalization of Indian rupee. It refers to the process of increased cross-border transaction of Indian currency, especially import-export trade, followed by the other current account transaction and then capital account transaction. This would enable the international settlements of trade in Indian rupees in foreign trades as opposed to the other currencies, including US dollar. Driving factor. The removal of seven Russian banks from SWIFT agreements as a part of Ukraine-induced economic sanctions against Russia was the trigger. The payment agreement assumed greater importance in 2022-2023 as India increased its dependence on discounted Russian oil, making it the second largest source of crude oil. India's effort. In July 2022, the RBI issued a circular on international trade settlement in Indian rupees, which underlined the terms not only for trade settlement but also cross-border transaction in rupees. An important component of this arrangement is that the rupee surplus balance can be used for capital and current account transition according to with mutual agreements. Thus, foreign entities hold rupees balance are allowed to invest in assets in India. More recently, in March 2023, the RBI put place the mechanism of rupee trade settlement with many as 18 countries. Banks from these countries have been allowed to open a special Vastro rupee account for settling payment in Indian rupees. In April 2023, India and Malaysia agreed to settle trade and Indian rupees as part of its foreign trade policy 2023. The government intends encourage the use of Indian currency in cross-border trade, added by new payment settlement framework that RBI introduced in July 2022. Significance. The most important advantage of internationalizing Indian rupee is to reduce the dependency on US dollar for foreign trade. It would further increase the bargaining power of India in international businesses. Expanding the use of rupee for international trade will reduce currency risk in foreign businesses by eliminating their own exposure and currency volatility. This can reduce the cost of doing businesses and hence helps in making export more competitive in a global market. Additionally, the need to maintain forex reserves can drastically reduce if the sizable share of Indian trade can be settled in terms of domestic currency. So, what are the major roadblocks of internationalization of rupee? First is rupee trade agreement not easy to implement. This was also the main reason why the India and Russia have suspended effort to settle bilateral trade in rupees. After the month's negotiation failed to convince the latter to keep rupees in its coffers. The rupee is not fully convertible. India's share of global export of goods is just about 2%, and this factor reduced the necessity of other countries to hold rupees. Consequently, Russia wanted the trade to be done in Chinese yuan, UAE dirham, or other currencies. India's trade deficit with major trading partners. India has a trade deficit with the major trading partners including China, UAE, Saudi Arabia, and Russia. In fact, India trade deficits with Russia, which implies that the latter would be saddled with a large rupee balances, was also why it has been reluctant to rupee ruble trade. Next is balancing exchange rate stability and domestic monetary policy. As the rupee become more internationalized, it is likely to become more vulnerable to external economic shock, such as changes in global interest rate or fluctuation in commodity prices. This would it make difficult to the central bank RBI to maintain both exchange rate stability and a domestically oriented monetary policy. Lesser control on money supply. When a currency is internationalized, both residents and non-residents can buy and sell domestically currency dominated financial instruments such as stock, bond, others and other securities. This means that the demand of supply of current countries' currencies can be influenced not just by the domestic but also external factor outside the country. If so happen, in this case of rupee, the RBI will have limited control over money supply within its own border, which could make it difficult to maintain a stable interest rate that in line with requirement of the domestic economy. Risk from fully convertible of rupees. For the rupee to be effectively internationalized, the government will have to remove restriction on any entity, domestic or foreign, from buying and selling rupee. This implies no restriction on the flow of capital in and out of the current countries, which would require a full convertibility on the capital account. So, what measure can be taken to facilitate rupee internationalization? First is emulating China. Among the emerging economies, China is the only country that has able to steadily internationalize its currency while maintaining control of its capital account. This has done so by finalizing the currency swap agreement between the central bank and China and 43 such countries, which assure the market that there would not be oversupply of the renminbi, creating the offshore market, its domestic currency that allow foreign entities to sell renminbi for dollar. Better planning. It would require India to have considerable thinking and planning to make rupee internationalization function in a manner that does not adversely affect the economic fundamentals. The government must carefully balance the benefit with the potential risk and take appropriate measure to ensure the stability of the economy. Focusing on enhancing export. India has made the modest attempt to facilitating rupee trade. The idea will take the time to gain acceptance. For the time being, the rupee's acceptance will potentially to limited countries that have a deficit with India. India will need to enroll other trade partners that would be able to use their rupee to buy goods from India. The US and European Union are the major export destination for India, and other would be oil exporting nation. Getting the latter into our fold sound plausible. Other concentrated step that the government can take: removal of restriction on buying and selling of domestic currency in both spot and forward market. Domestic firms being able to invoice, export and import in their own currency. Foreign firms, financial institution, government institution and individual being able to hold the country's currency and financial instrument. So if you want to download this PDF, please check on the description below, and thanks for watching, and don't forget to subscribe, share, like and comment.